on the East Side Dave Show, baby. You're going
I actually mean an extra special edition of the Eastside Game Show with Roy Harter, End of Time Series Volume 45. And I gotta tell you, if the show is gonna be anything like the pre-show setup we just had, you're in for a great one, ladies and gentlemen. Now, without further ado, let's go over my man right over there, Mr. Eastside, David McDowell, baby.
Woo!
There he is.
Yeah.
I got your back, buddy. I got your back.
Thank you, Roy. Roy, you always have my back. I've known that since 2010.
You know who doesn't have my back?
You know who's killing me these days?
I'm going to take a wild guess, and I'm going to go with
Robert.
Mr. Robert.
Robert.
Yeah. I'm glad it's you this time, Robert.
Robert,
not me.
Robert, I'm just going to ask you straight up. I mean, I'll have to set it up for the audience because I want to do just an inside radio type of thing. I'm just going to be honest. Are you retarded? Are you a retarded person?
No.
Do you have? No. Okay. So for 5 years, the East Side Dave Show has been going strong on Compound Media. That deserves a round of applause.
Woo!
And for 5 years, it's Drew and Garrett in the booth. The goddamn dream team.
Yeah.
Drew with the fucking directing and the visuals and the things. Garrett with the videos and the music and the sound and the calls, everything. See, look at this. Look at this guy. Look at that professional shot right there. Everything, a seamless thing. These guys are fucking Lennon and McCartney of Compound Media production, okay? That's what they are. That's who they are. About 10 minutes, 12 minutes before each East Side Dave show, I get the Skype call and I say, okay, here's what we got to do. Every single week, I feel like I am just trying to quickly do the bullet points of the stuff that we got to get to. So we set up a nicely produced show. And every week, Robert makes jokes or says strange comments, Roy. Does weird things. For instance.
Even weirder than me, David.
When I told Garrett, I asked Garrett, I said in the way of, hey, we better have this music ready. Okay, we better have like this specific music ready for a specific bit. Okay?
Yeah.
Robert then goes in, he goes, whoa, Dave, that's Garrett who does that. That's not me. So you better have some respect. I go, well, that was fucking respectful. Yes, you said that. You implied that I was disrespectful to Garrett, who I fucking love, and I love Drew, and you're not gonna fucking portray me as some fucking guy who doesn't love Garrett and Drew. And when you said, hey, Dave, well, Garrett gets the music, he's off, or don't give him such a hard time, you're making me look like a fucking bad guy. Why? I have no idea. And every single week I say, just don't needle me before the show. I've got enough life problems. I have enough drama going on in my regular life. I just like basic questions and basic answers 10 to 15 minutes before the show. Very boring stuff. Do we have this video? Yes. Do we have that video? Yes. Can we get the music? Yes. I like boring checklist shit. But your fucking retarded brain has to always make little jokes and comments and little fucking things, and it's always unhelpful to the point where it sets up a fucking bad vibe, because now I'm fired up and I don't like to be fired up by the likes of you. And why is he so big? He's almost as big as Roy. Shrink Robert down. Andrea can stay the same. Shrink him down. Down. Just like the East Side Dave song said, down. Now, Robert, you don't seem to understand. I text you things. I appreciate you. I appreciate your work. I do things like this. I have literally one criticism that I consistently ask of you before the show. Just nice black and white answers, dry, boring, unfunny, unentertaining answers, because there's a lot going on up here. So I can't get fucking confused with your little jokes.
Okay.
Do you understand what I was saying about the thing with Garrett? That wasn't your... You didn't need to tell it to me. And quite frankly, if you're thinking that I was mistaken, then think about that, the fact that you're saying to me that well, Dave, Garrett does the audio for the show, not me. As if I didn't know that. Garrett's been in the fucking booth for 5 years. You're on the desk. How would I not know that Garrett and Drew do the production for the show? How is that possible that I would not know that? I knew who I was talking to, and quite frankly, I believe I said it in a relatively polite way. Matter of fact, perhaps. But polite, respectful, yes. Garrett, was I respectful when I... Can we get the unfrozen Garrett, please? I asked you.
Unfrozen caveman Garrett.
My quote was, we better have the music ready for that segment.
Correct.
And it was in no way like, hey, you piece of shit, Garrett, or this or that. We better have the music ready for that segment is pretty cut and dry, pretty mild, I think.
It was more Bobby's reaction that caught me off guard.
Bobby's reaction was fucking weird.
Yeah.
And Robert, you think he's joking. He's not.
It's very befitting on Fat Tuesday.
I'm telling you, this is Garrett being for real. Your reaction was fucking strange that you're telling me, whoa, Dave, don't yell at Garrett. Or just so you know, Garrett does the audio. Don't be so demanding. You don't realize what you're saying, but you're making me look and sound bad in front of Garrett, who I did not fucking disrespect by saying, quote, maybe we should have the music ready. What's so funny?
I don't think you can say quote and then say that. I don't think that's how those sentences work together.
That's what I said. Robert, that is what I said. Garrett, did I say anything else?
Like, it was such a nothing, I didn't even remember what you said.
Exactly. But
I remember Bobby getting very mad.
Here's the thing. So why are you starting? What was the point of your comments? To instigate shit? To start shit? To needle me? To cause drama? What was the deal?
No, Dave, this typically happens before the show, as you pointed out. You were irritated with me going in. You were saying something to me prior, and what you said to Garrett...
I wasn't irritated with you going in. I don't know what you're talking about.
No, going into the statement with Garrett. You were already irritated with me for needling you, as you said, and I didn't mean to. I apologize. But you were, and you were going, and then you said that in a tone. I thought... I just, like, I know how much you love Garrett and Drew. They're the best, as you always say. And it sounded in a way that you were addressing me, not Garrett. So I just wanted to make sure that the heat you were bringing, and I apologize, it was a mistake in my mind that you...
I know who I'm talking to. You don't need to be my fucking C-3PO and interpret my statements for people.
Nice Star Wars reference,
Dave. I know who I'm talking to, and I know what I'm doing before the show, and I know what needs to be communicated in a very quickly, timely fashion, but with the respect that Garrett and Drew deserve, which I provided when I had my fucking little request for a song, for a bit.
Speaking of respect, David.
No, wait a second, Roy. So I'm sorry. You can make it up to me, Robert.
Okay.
You can make it up to me right now. Can we have some sad music, Garrett? Is that okay? I don't want to yell at you.
I don't think he has it ready. The music.
Can you have some nice, happy?
If you don't have it, Garrett, I can probably play some.
Happy, delightful music. Robert, you're going to apologize to me and to Roy Harter for upsetting him. His beard turned gray because of this kind of fucking drama. This guy had jet black beard.
Redhead, David. Red. Ginger.
Dave, I am sorry.
He had a ginger black beard.
I am sorry for irritating you before the show, for stepping out of line, and for turning Roy's...
Hold on. Robert. It sounds a little cold, I mean. A little hard, a little... You know what, Dave, man? You make me feel so nice, baby. You make me feel so sweet, Daddy. you know, something just a little bit nicer. I mean, that was, again, you're very gruff. All right, let's hear.
Dave, man, I am very sorry for irritating you before the show, and that's for good. Turning Roy's ginger black beard to gray.
Yeah. Yep. He'll never be the same again. He was going to be a pirate. That was his pirate name, Ginger Blackbeard.
Now I got to be Santa Claus again.
Is that all, Robert?
Yep.
That's the extent of the apology?
That's what you told me to say. What more do you want, Dave?
Well, I mean, you know, I want... See, this is very fresh. You're very fresh. You got no... Just no, hey, Dave, man. You know what?
I said the hey, Dave, man. That's how I started. Remember, you said that was good. I got it in there.
How about a little dance, and then we can move on with the program.
I mean, sound like I'm playing this game.
It's hard to see you dance if you're not standing.
I am standing. That's the unfortunate thing here, Dave.
Oh.
I'm just that short.
Okay. He's gotten short. Well, those are good moves. I like those moves. Okay. We're all good, then. Are we all good? Are we all squared away?
Yeah.
You sure are, buddy.
That's how you handle situations, Roy.
Yeah, better than me, because I would have freaked out. Good thing you guys didn't.
How would have you freaked out?
I would have started screaming, David, like a psycho. You know how Roy rage is.
Oh, yeah.
I know. I've gotten the Roy rage, though. That's the problem. Is Roy rage like AIDS or something? Because I believe I've contracted Roy rage.
You know, because
you do catch it in the same way.
No, but here's the thing. David,
Dick
I do understand.
In the ass.
I understand where you're coming from. And I think this fucking pandemic has got us all a bit crazy.
That's true. And I have told people that you have to understand that you have to allow for a little bit of mental illness, more mental illness out of the Dave man than
usual.
But
now that it's now that it is
25 to 40% more mentally ill than before. So yeah, that is true. And I've stated that to folks. I hope they remember that.
Well, thankfully, the pandemic is now on its way out. It's passing by, and things are going to start to get back to quote-unquote normal very soon, David.
God bless you. Now, is that Stevie Lou? I thought I saw a Steve is on hold, but, I mean, is it Stevie Lou, or is it just some...
Just a
some,
Steve.
Do we know who this Steve is? Let's put him on, just
probably
for fun.
Steve from New Jersey, the champion.
Hey, guys, it's Stevie Lou here. How are you?
Oh, it's Stevie Lou. Oh, I didn't hear that.
I was listening to it. I got really nervous.
All right.
Robert, I felt like a flashback to my own experiences at the Dave show, the East Side Dave show. So I wanted to just tell Robert, do not smash that desk. Whatever you do,
see, that's
do not
a great piece
Andrew
of advice.
Will hold you back.
That's right.
Love you guys.
That's right.
See you later.
That's it, Stevie? All right. Thank you, Stevie. Stevie Lou chiming in.
We love you, Stevie.
And
good
it's a good
you.
Piece of advice, Robert. I would not break anything. And by the way, Naval Commander Andrea is there, and now she has to witness all of this. Imagine how horrified she is. She told me this is what when we get into these type of discussions, it's more frightening than war for Naval Commander Andrea. She told me she saw 15 Somalians get beheaded, and that was less graphic than a pre-East Side Dave show confrontation.
Yeah.
She told me you just texted her code red. What does that mean,
I
Dave?
Did. No, don't either. It's Andrea, wait till 8:31. 8:31, Andrea, for code red. You know what it, you know. You do have the wire, though, in your piano wire, Andrea. Okay. Now, listen. We have a lot to do. All right, is
Show's
everything
over,
okay?
Dave.
Robert, by the way, Robert said, Roy, and since we've all kissed and made up, right, Robert? Robert said, hey, after the show, we need a long fucking phone call, Dave, man. I mean, I'm not throwing you under the bus now. I'm saying I fucked up how you said that. But basically, my point was, by God, at 8:30, you think I want to spend one more second with the East Side Dave show? not, not, I mean, I love Roy, Drew, Garrett. Well, you know, Andrew and Bo. And Andrea. But Robert, Flute, me, and Jimmy, they consistently make me want to kill myself. I put Stevie in the good list, too, after that thing. But
shocker, buddy.
Stevie's good. Robert, Flutesy, Jimmy, in the bad camp. But Robert, thank you so much. First of all, you've never looked more like Salman Rushdie than ever before. You're the hair's growing out. And yeah, I think you need to write something about how Islam is bad, and you need to date a supermodel. I mean, you're very Salman Rushdie right now. I like it.
Thank you.
So we are going to do something, Roy, that we had planned. Should we go into the videos? Because I know Bo and Big A and Flutesy all sent videos, and they were all excited. Now, as far as Bo and Big A go, they actually sent their best joke. They said they were going to do a little update, and then they were going to have a little battle between each other. Who has the best joke, Andrew or Bo? So I think let's go with one of those two. How about Andrew, first of all? Let's see what he's... Here we go.
Hi, Dave and Roy.
Is he in hospital?
How have you guys been doing? I'm good. I've been trying to keep you busy and do photoshops and try to be creative. And also, I have follow-up doctor appointments this month.
Can we pause for a sec? Pause for just 2 seconds. He's giving us a little update, Roy.
Yeah, is Big A okay? I mean, I didn't know he was in the hospital.
No, it's follow-up appointments. He's good.
Yeah, he's good. These are just follow-up appointments. He just wanted to give a little update of what he's up to. And he's going to follow-up appointments for the doctor.
Oh, okay. Thank God.
Okay, we can continue.
Yeah, and dive. I went to Atlanta City recently, and I got a secret comedy show in Connecticut. And watching TV and, you know, trying not to be so bored. Everybody loves bad puns.
Oh, okay. He's got. Here's his jokes now. Okay.
Sorry. A job at the bank. On my very first day, a woman asked me to check her balance. So I pushed her over. Adams are untrustworthy little critters and make up every thing.
Okay.
I was going to make myself a belt out of watches, but then I realized it'd be a waste of time. Which countries capital has the fastest growing population? Ireland. Every day it's Dublin. Why was King Arthur's army too tired to fight? They had too many sleepless nights. I'm a big fan of whiteboards. I find them quite remarkable.
I don't. Oh, because you can remark them. Whiteboard.
Does a pirate pay for corn? Buccaneer.
Okay. But we have to blow him up.
That's my time.
Oh, there it is. He finished it.
Okay. Speaker. Yeah.
I was 2 seconds away from blowing him up, but he got through it.
Yeah, he got that closer in there. That was brilliant.
So his best joke was actually 9 or 10 jokes that he Googled.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Just trying to make sure
that delivery. It's all in the delivery. And that's with true. That,
and I
great.
Do like the way, for the whiteboard joke, that they're remarkable. I like the way he said remarkable. Like he was, Billy Crystal with a, you look marvelous, baby. Like he really, he looked like that guy, Fernando, or whatever. Yeah. I don't know. Go Google that fucking character. It was 35 years ago. What do you want from me? All right. So I think that was pretty good. That was some good stuff right there from Andrew. Okay.
Excellent job, Andrew.
Yes. What did you think about that, Roy?
I thought it was brilliant, as always. You know me, I'm a big fan of Andrew.
Yeah, I thought it was very good. Robert, Andrea?
Oh, yeah.
Thought it was very good. Started strong. May have dipped a little in the middle, but then he came back and finished really strong with the remarkable joke.
Oh, wow. Yeah. He just destroyed Andrew by saying it dipped in the middle, like his fucking stomach. Did you hear what Robert just said? Made fun of his waistline?
Andrew's not going to like that, Robert.
It dips in the middle. That's what he gets. He goes, Robert goes, What's the similarity between the middle of Big A's set and his fucking taint? It dips in the middle. Okay, anyway. Let's go to Bo. No, I'm just kidding. That was a good joke, Robert, about the in the middle thing. Bo? Is Bo,
we're in the middle of a pandemic, but why do we really need to wear something that just blocks our airwaves? Really, guys. I feel like I'm out of breath, like I barely survived something after I have to take off this mask after having to wear it for a bunch of hours. Dr. Fauci, he's a dummy.
That was it?
Well,
that was the video.
Topical?
Was there a joke there? Or was the joke Dr. Fauci's a dummy?
He couldn't breathe, like he just almost survived something.
Yeah. I like how Bo's stream of consciousness is like a guy with an enlarged prostate trying to take a piss. Just
yeah, kind
of stops. A lot of misdirection.
It was so simple. You know what I asked those two guys to do? Give me a quick update and your best joke. Neither one. Mission accomplished. Uh-uh.
I think you played a pretty good joke on you, Dave.
Oh.
I guess so.
Damn.
All right, we have to vote. It's going to be between Big A or Bo. I suggest we let Drew Garrett and Roy vote.
I'll go first here because as Andrew's video was amazing and all his jokes are great, Bo had me on the floor laughing. So, and that is a lie because I showed it on the camera. I wasn't actually on the floor. I just want to clear that up. But I was laughing.
All right, let's go to Roy next, and then Garrett. Okay.
Both brilliant performances in their own right. I like the fact that Bobo's was more topical. However, Big A had more quantity in his jokes. Because of that fact, I'm a big quantity over quality guy. I'm going with Big A on this one.
It's a rare. You don't hear that often. You don't hear about I'm a quantity over quality type of person. That's interesting. Okay, and now Garrett is the tiebreaker. This thing is for the virtual joke championship. Okay, the very first ever Eastside Dave Show virtual joke championship between the two biggest heavy hitters of the Eastside Dave Show, Big A Andrew Gold and Bobo / Bo. Okay, so, because I always forget Bo's real name. So, Garrett, it comes down to you.
This is a tough one, Dave.
Oh, please. Okay, there you go.
Because it's really like, who do I want not mad at me next week?
It's a great point, though. Let me just say this. Andrew, big hands, has the ability to crush a skull with those things. Bo,
grudges.
You know.
Yeah. And
I know.
There's more of a chance of Big A showing up here. But, I don't know. Big A had all those puns. I really like puns. But Bobo really killed me with, like I just survived something. So I'm going with Bobo.
Oh, Oh, he's going with Bobo! Bobo's the winner! Oh, they said, wow, the shocker!
Wow!
That is a show. That's one of the biggest shocks in Eastside Dave's show history. I am going to call it right now. I did not see that coming. Bobo, somehow, I mean, Andrew was like Henny Youngman over there. One-liner, 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 boom, boom, boom. And here comes Bo, all dressed up, looking crazy. And he takes home the championship. That is unbelievable. Well, I feel amazed about that. Roy, what do you think about that, huh?
I think that Big A is probably going to come in there and crush a couple more skulls. That's honestly what's going to happen. Because he's not going to take that very lightly, guys. I'm telling you. Big A, just remember, Roy Harter voted for you.
Big A, it's true. Big A does not like losing to Bo. I think Big A can lose to other people. But when Bo beats him, it's extra bitter for Andrew.
Oh, yeah. You guys have no idea what you're in for.
No. He's going to kill all of them.
Hey, Dave.
They have an Ali Frazier type of deal.
Hey, Dave.
Well, I'd like to get, if possible, I'd like to talk to the winner at some point, to Bo. Let's see if we can get what. No way! He's getting lost right now!
How's everything going? What's up, Bo?
Bo! You're here with us!
At first, I'd like to say thank you guys for having me on today.
Great! Great, how are you? You look great. You're looking nice with the long hair. Look at this.
Yeah, it's been a few days. My hair cutting place was on vacation.
You also go every 3 days to get your hair cut?
No, usually like every 10. I try to go like every 10 to 20 days.
Now, are we washing our hands and doing those things?
Yeah, I'm doing everything they keep saying I'm supposed to do.
How about the butt, Bo? Do we wipe a lot with the butt when we poo, or how many wipes do we get there, buddy?
However many needs to be done.
However many, that's the answer. That's the answer right there. Because, Bo, you know, I like anyone else, I like 3 wipes and I'm out. But here's the thing, if I see even one speck of brown, I'm going to wipe. So if it takes me 35 wipes, I'm going to do it. But I got to be honest with you, Bo. Sometimes my butt bleeds. Does that ever happen? You look down at the paper tissue there, at the toilet paper, and you get little specks of brown and red? Little blood and, you know, does that ever happen to you, buddy?
It's happened.
Yeah, it has.
Like today?
Yeah.
No, not today, but it's happened before.
Let me ask you another question there, little pal. Do we shave down our pubic area, or what are we doing? Are we keeping that natural? Do we do nail scissors, maybe? We trim it, or what are we doing there?
It's trimmed hair.
Trimmed, yeah. With what? Scissor, what kind of scissor?
No, usually a razor.
Whoa, careful, Bo. Roy Harter had an accident. He can't have kids anymore. With a razor. You gotta be like careful with that razor.
It's more of an electric trimmer kind of thing.
Careful, Bo. You're gonna drop in the bathtub. You're gonna fucking electrocute your stupid little ass.
Well, I don't careful. Use it in the bathtub.
Bo, don't stand in the toilet bowl while doing your fucking pubes, though. I heard you stand in the toilet bowl and then you drop it.
Which room do you do it in?
The bathroom.
Oh, he does it in the bathroom. He does it. Let me ask you a question.
Over the carpet.
We brush our teeth. We're brushing our teeth every day, aren't we?
Yep, I am.
Yeah? How many times we jerk off, too? A day.
It's very random.
It's very, you know, let's put it in a week scenario. 7 times a week, 4 times a week, 8 times, 12?
Might be 8 times a week.
8 times a week. Like the Beatles, Roy.
Like
8 days
Beatles.
A week, Roy.
They wrote a song about it.
Yeah. Let me ask you something, little pal. You just beat Andrew in the very first ever virtual joke contest. What did you think about that? I was shocked about that.
I am honored to have won this contest.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll tell you what. If Big A dies first, you gonna piss on his grave since you guys are rivals, or what? That'd be a nice little move.
I might if I drank a lot before I visited his grave.
Robert, make sure you tell Andrew Bobo plans on pissing on his grave.
He's watching.
Next week. Robert's going to tell Andrew what you're planning. Don't think that that won't get you executed by March. But let me ask you something. If you had to do a painting, okay, and let's just, and we had to choose one bodily function to use as the paint, we're doing shit, we're doing piss, or are we doing cum? Those are your three options.
What about blood?
I would use my own jizz.
As opposed to someone else's?
Yes! He would use his jizz, he would not use Roy's jizz, not Robert's jizz, just his own. Hey, that makes him more sane than 50% of the East Side Dave show cast right there. That's pretty good, Bo.
Smart.
Bo, one more bodily function thing. Guy comes in, says, I'm going to give you $1 million. You either got to eat a shit brownie or do a shot of cum. What are we doing there, buddy?
I'll probably eat my own shit.
Bo, a second guy comes in. He says, I'm a makeup artist, and I need you to either put shit all over your face or cum all over your face. What are we doing?
I'll probably take the shit.
Bo, you feeling okay? How do you feel to do that?
I'm actually feeling a bit good that I've been the last couple of days. I just dealt with a bad cold.
Oh, no. Really? Hold on. I got someone who wants to talk to you real quick.
Hi, baby. Hi, best friend. I miss your fat, chewy, chubby ass. Hey, baby, you love me? Andy, do you love me?
Okay, little baby.
I miss you, baby. I miss sucking your dick. I miss fucking you. I miss doing all kinds of things to your hot ass. To your fat hot ass. To that fat chew hot ass, baby. Best friends. Eat each other's ass, best friends. Gonna fuck you first and last, best friends. Gonna fuck you till you come, best friends. Gonna fuck you till you're numb, best friends. Gonna fuck your ass raw, best friends. Gonna fuck you really hard, best friend.
Beautiful.
I love you, best friend. I miss you so much. I miss getting AIDS from you and all the nice fun things.
I miss you too, little Davey.
Okay, bye, you little fucking asshole.
Bo, you're the best, man. I'm glad I voted for you. You deserve the win.
Bo, you won it. You're the champ. You're the virtual Joe contest champ. So congratulations, Bo. And we'll see you later, pal, okay?
All right. Thank you, guys.
Bye. Bo, everyone.
Yeah. Bo.
Woo. Roy, I really do fear for Bo's safety. Once Andrew Gold finds out how he was screwed out of a virtual joke competition, bloodshed.
I got news for you, David. I think Big A already knows because he actually watches the show. So he's probably already he's already pissed, I assure you.
Speaking of someone who does not watch the show, her name is Flutesy. this fucking bitch. Don't worry, Robert. As much as you alienate me and anger me, and you're clearly there to needle me, drive me insane, make me lose any semblance of sanity that I once had, as much as you do all of those things, Flutesy is the worst person in the United States of America. How about a round of applause, actually? Something we can all agree on.
Should she because be deported
after
back to
Roy
her home
did a very passionate segment of Roy's Cool School where he implored people, stop doing every goddamn rinky-dink fucking podcast that you can do because it devalues you and then it waters you down for the East Side Dave Show. After Roy does this huge fucking segment, look what Flutesy tweets out. Tag me in a podcast you'd like to see me in.
The East Side Dave Show.
Yeah. By the way, Andrea did write that. Andrea did say the East Side Dave Show, and I thank you, Andrea, for that. That was classy. But so then later on, she goes, "Why am I on the Scheiser list today?" Because she doesn't watch. And then furthermore, she was booked to be here tonight, to Skype in tonight. And you know who fucking called last night at goddamn 7:30 and fucking said, Dave, man, I can't go in on Tuesday? Flutesy, Roy. And because of that, I believe I hear something. Oh, yeah, it's a Scheiser list.
Scheiser!
Scheiser! You're the one that we despise.
Now, I told her if she comes onto the show soon, she can get off the Scheiser list. But for now, Roy, you know what? Double Scheiser list, Roy! Double Scheiser!
Double Scheiser!
Scheiser, you're the one that we despise!
And by the way, that photo of Flutesy on the Scheiser list, that is no Photoshop. We actually took, when she was doing titty bumps, that's immediately the picture
shitty
that we
bumps.
Were able to get
shitty
of her afterwards.
Bumps.
Yeah.
Shitty bumps!
Hey, Dave, let me ask you this. Did she give you a reason why she wasn't able to appear tonight? Or did she just say, hey, I'm not going in? What was the reason? I'm just curious, genuinely curious.
The text said, I'm on the rag and I'm bleeding worse, I don't know, than some sort of Vietnam person who gets their legs cut off or some sort of... you know how she texts, Roy?
Yeah,
something about being on the rag and bleeding a lot. Blood all over the place. And she said the blood was discolored as well.
Huh.
She said, as far as she knows, it's the first time... This is her Twitter. As far as she knows, this is the first time that shit is coming out of her vagina while she's on the rag right now. Yeah. There's fecal matter that is emanating from her vagina. So that's why.
That doesn't sound good, David. I hope she'll be okay.
A couple of internal hole breaches.
Andrea, you're a woman.
Yes, allegedly.
Is that normal?
Sort of
what she said is they're as big as chocolate chips. She said from like specifically Chips Ahoy chocolate chips.
Okay, I mean, if it's coming from her butt, that's normal. She's dehydrated, yeah. But I think she just doesn't understand which hole is which.
That's a good point, too, Roy. She often gets vagina and anus confused.
Yeah, she could confuse her ass in the hole in the ground.
Okay, you know what? Yeah. You know what? Andrea's right. She's dyslexic with that kind of shit. Now, I was also told that Andrea and Robert are going to do some we're also going to have an in-house comedy contest. We're doing a virtual comedy contest tonight and a live comedy contest tonight. Is that what I'm led to believe here? All right, let's get ready for that. But since we're talking about Flutesy, let's do the fucking Flutesy video real quick. There we go.
Hey, everybody. What's up?
Hi, Flutesy. Going good, thanks.
What have I been up to lately? I don't know. I drank last night for my friend's birthday, and I'm a little hungover right now. But here I am, making this for you. And what else have I been up to? Nothing, I guess. Because I'm fluting, and I'm working, and I'm fluting, and I'm taking lingerie photos.
Just for two seconds. You have to, I am going to remind myself never to ask the East Side Dave Show what they're up to ever again for the rest of my life, Roy.
Good point, Dave. I just asked,
give me a little update.
What's up?
But her update is jack and shit. I'm up to jack and shit at this point. Yes, Andrew.
I have an idea. You want the same output, but you might have to give different input to each cast member to get that.
You're right.
That correct output.
You're right. You're right. You're right. You're right. I'm talking with the cast of One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. I can't treat Martini the same way I would treat R.P. McMurphy. I understand what you're saying, Andrea. Thank you. That's why she's Naval Commander Andrea. And I'm not. Okay? I'm landlocked, Roy. Okay? I'm a fucking landlocked asshole. Let's see what Flutesy's saying.
And I'm taking lingerie photos. You know, that's life. So here we go. Guess okay, the tune.
Go play your song. What the hell song she played, but I'm led to believe that she at least gave us the fucking answer in the email so that we finally are able to play a flute game once and for all, because the last three goddamn fucking flute songs she sent, she forgets one little important detail, the answer to the competition. We have the answer here, Roy. I don't know the song. Do you know it? Why don't you take a guess?
I honestly I don't know this one, David.
Oh my. Does anyone know it, Robert?
She got me.
Andrea?
No idea.
Oh, no. Garrett?
Never heard it before in my life.
Oh, my God. Drew?
I saw the answer. So, yes, I have it.
Can you give us a hint as to what this would be? Because we're all stumped.
We usually get hints. That's true.
It's a name that's been in the news in the last week or two.
Donald Trump! Is there a movie? Wait, there's no Donald Trump movie. It's got to be a movie. It's got to be a movie. Okay, there's a name. It's been in a week. It's been in the news the last couple weeks. Okay. There's Okay, I'm going to say the movie.
I know it. Now I know it.
I'm going to say Indiana Jones.
No, it's fuck Tom Brady, dude.
Oh! Is it the Patriot with Mel Gibson?
Can't spell Patriot because without
Tom
Wyatt.
Brady was on the Patriots. Oh, man. I am stumped. Does anyone have. Drew, give us one more hint and then we have to move on.
Sometimes you feel like you need to take from people that have a lot. Maybe give it to people that might not have a lot.
Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves.
Democrats party.
Robin! It's Robin Hood is the correct answer. Good, Andrea wins! Naval Commander Andrea is the champion of the flute game today. There you go, Andrea.
I love that movie because...
I didn't know that the score to Robin Hood just went...
I watched that movie a ton when I was a little kid. I don't know how I didn't get that.
Yeah. I would have never gotten that in 8 fucking million years. Okay, here we go. It's Robert. It's Andrea. It's going to be an in-person comedy contest right now.
Get there!
Drew, Carol, and Roy all judging. This is very exciting. So, who is first here? Okay, Robert was sheepishly looking at Andrea, and then Andrea sheepishly put her hand up. So I believe, Andrea, you're going first because, well, it looks like you were just pressured into going first. So get up there.
I'm going to try to make most of my decisions under pressure.
Here she goes.
All right. So I talked to my app-developing brother in the rapidly declining Silicon Valley, and he was mad that his neighborhood now has an hourly hotel. I came away with more questions than information. First, I Googled the difference between hotel and motel. In general, hotels are multi-stories. motels are single stories, and hourly hotels are crime stories. My brother was worried that it would drive down his property value, and at least hourly hotels blend in better than, say, a dumping station, nuclear power plant, or prison, also known as a mandatory extended stay hotel. I worked at a traditional hotel. I know what hard work it is to turn over a room. Makes me wonder how it's done at La Cunta Inn. Housekeeping must operate at the speed of a NASCAR pit crew. And turn down service? What's that like? Every hour someone comes in and incinerates the bedding? And amenities? I'm glad you asked. They don't bother with the shampoos and the soaps, but they do have massive quantities of lotion. And the nightstand Bible? They do have one. It's just been hollowed out to store condoms. How ironic. Literal barriers for sex, though, not the type Jesus intended. A normal hotel will charge you extra for incidentals like smoking or having a pet. But the hourly considers it common courtesy to light up after completing an act with another mammal. And what is their incidental threshold? Some misdemeanors, all felonies, indoor dining. Normal hotels require a credit card to pay for damages or missing items, but the Super 8 Ball strikes me as more of a cash economy. They require some collateral, like your car or phone or baby.
Yeah.
You can get these items back after the clerk inspects the room. Okay, got a full condom Bible. Let's see, full gallon bottle of lotion. Oh, thank you. You already incinerated the sheets. But perhaps this will inspire my brother to fight back against this blacklit stain on his community and launch a new app, the hourly version of Airbnb, the Hump Dump.
Andrea Bryant! Naval Commander Andrea! Andrea Bryant, her given name! Naval Commander Andrea is her nickname. Wow, that was good, Robert.
It's gonna be a tough one.
It's gonna be hard to beat.
It's Fat Tuesday, guys, or as Chris Stanley calls it, Tuesday.
I know
and
him.
That's our last day of going gluttonous and eating a lot before we fast for 40 days to prepare for the death of our friend Jesus. I think this is bullshit, and I will only do it once a year. So that means Jimmy. If this is the year where you're going to off yourself, you got a real narrow window.
Oh, no. God damn.
Dave, as you know, Catholics, they celebrate the holiday by not eating meat on Fridays. I had to explain to Stevie Lou this didn't mean he had to stop sucking cock on Fridays. Now, the less holy Christians, Dave, the non-Catholics, if you will, they celebrate by giving something up for 40 days. And I think Flutesy should give something up this Lent. She should give up being retarded. Send your videos in on time, give us the answers, and actually watch the Eastside Dave Show.
Oh, 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 oh. Boom. Boom.
Lent Boom. And Easter really does bring up some questions. Like, we get mad at people for exploiting tragedy all the time. Like David Hogg for making a pillow. We get mad at Jimmy, or at least the fans do anytime he's on the Eastside Dave Show, for exploiting his tragedy. And Jim Norton gets yelled at for exploiting the tragedy that is Sam Roberts. So why does Jesus get away with this holiday? Why are we allowed to just celebrate Jesus' death? It feels like the Catholic Church is taking advantage of the situation. That's my time.
Robert, the jokes were good, but again, I feel you have a slight obsession with various people at SiriusXM who, with all due respect, I'm not sure that they know who you are. And it comes across as crazy that you're going after these people who don't really have a connection to you.
Which one would you like me to address first, Dave?
Why are you so fixated? You got the job at Compound Media. Why do you still? I worked with these people, and I have no bitterness. But you can't leave. Specifically, you cannot leave Chris Pepper Stanley and Sam Roberts alone. There's a straight up obsession there. You got to move on at some point.
I can't wait. Dave, if there's ever a day when you and I stop working, I can't wait to hear Robert's jokes about me.
Roy was the nicest guy ever. He played the best music.
I know that will be your joke. It'll be the whole thing will be, Dave is such a fucking asshole. He fucking goes after my shit before the show. He goes after my black ass during the show. He goes after my black ass after the show.
Robert Tamburo at the Apollo.
I see it more as I see a star in the same way I saw a star in Flutesy, but both and with Jimmy. But all three of you make me crazy because unlike Bo and Andrew, who are doing everything that they can with their God-given talent, right? Instead, you know what?
I take it I didn't win the contest.
Happy. Yes, I'm in a good mood. I'm in a good mood. I'm going to stay that way.
So I did not win, to be clear.
No. I'm just saying, you can be frustrated. You people can be frustrating. But listen, we have to decide who won that competition. I believe the voting is going to start with Drew. Drew, did Naval Commander Andrea or Robert win this very tight in-person comedy contest?
Well, Dave, I have to say that it was very... Naval Commander Andrea got it from me. Thank you.
Yay! Oh! Thank you, Drew.
Naval Commander Andrea got it from Drew. All right, let's go with a Roy again.
David, I know this is going to be a very controversial decision, and Andrew, your set was brilliant, but I'm giving this one to Robert, because I like a little controversy, you know what I'm saying?
No. Let me explain something, though, before you say that. Let me explain something. When you say that, they listen to you. Then they see that as a green light to fucking be a fucking pain in the ass to me 5 minutes before the show. So can you please say you like controversy, but not with me and before the show every fucking Tuesday?
Good point, David. Let me rephrase that, gentlemen. Wait. Hold on. I like controversy, but I don't like it when it's directed at Miss Champion over here.
Just 15 minutes before the show. For Christ's sakes.
Yeah, definitely. 15 minutes before the show, for sure.
Garrett! Garrett! Oh, yeah, the music! Not the music! This was the thing that got us into the argument in the first place, and we haven't even played it all night tonight. For Christ's sake, this is why I'm ready to... That's it. It's time. No, it really is time. It's time.
Oh, no,
it is.
No,
it's
no, time. Dave.
It would be good for us. It would be good for the show.
It would be good for the show, but you know what? It would kind of fuck me as far as my royalties concerned. Because I like to continue receiving them. And once you're gone, and I got to deal with residual... No, let's not do that, David.
Is your life insurance policy up to date?
Life insurance policy, Andrea? What the hell is that?
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe has one for me.
This was the song. We were supposed to play this song during the Big A bit, and then here. So what I had said was, hey, let's make sure that we have the Clockwork Orange music for Big A. At which point, Robert screamed at me, "Hey, don't disrespect Garrett." And I'm like, "No, you know what?
Now this song is giving the Dave Man flashbacks."
No, I'm having flashbacks to 1 hour ago. 1 hour ago, I was ready to do this. How about this? What about this? Right?
I haven't seen you angry in a long time. Hey, remember last time you gave a little...
That was close.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's how Xander Berkeley went in Terminator 2.
Whoa. Let's do a Inglourious Bastards move. Right here.
Oh.
Dave, you cut yourself. I bet you just cut yourself. All
right, hold on. Seriously. No big deal. Ready? Let's see if this works.
David? Oh, David.
Oh, no.
David. Just like in wrestling, huh? All right, that's enough, David. That would be enough.
Ooh. Didn't really come out as well as the guy in Inglourious Bastards, Roy. I was trying for it. Now it looks more like Ash Wednesday. Well, I guess it's not perfect timing, being that it's Fat Tuesday. All right. Well, that's it. I am going to go call a doctor. Let's get out of here because I'm feeling a little lightheaded. And we salvaged tonight's episode. It was unsalvageable, but we salvaged it. About 5 minutes in, we salvaged it.
Wait, did Garrett deliver his verdict or not?
Oh yeah, Garrett, who won the fucking cup?
I don't vote for traitors, Andrea.
Andrea, Naval Commander Andrea. She is the in-person comedy contest winner tonight. She joins her boyfriend, Bo, as the virtual comedy contest winner. The two of them. And what do they have? They are going to win, Roy, a trip for two to Bayonne, New Jersey.
Yeah! Come on! Don't worry, Bo. I'll drive. Right.
Andrea,
it's fine.
You and Bo have gotten all expenses paid vacation to Bayonne, New Jersey. For this Thursday. This Thursday only.
Almost all expenses paid, David. We didn't cover the transportation.
Roy's right. Yeah. Almost. You just have to pay lodging, gas, bills, and you have to get yourselves there. But we are going to give you a $5 gift certificate to a local diner in Bayonne, New Jersey.
Ooh, okay? Tip not included. Yeah.
Hey, pretty Dave, I'm a little worried about your bleeding over there, so I'm going to play this one out really quick, all right?
Yeah, I'm a little lightheaded. All right.
Damn, it's been a real fine day. Damn, it's been a real fine day. Ain't got blues, ain't got time for bad news. But damn, it's been a real fine day. There's a whole lot of trouble out in this world. Yeah, a whole lot of worry, a whole lot of worry. Now that I had you come into my life, there's a whole lot of reason to stay me. Damn, it's been a real fine day. Damn, it's been a real fine day. Got on my new shoes, ain't no way we're gonna lose. Cause damn, it's been a real fine day.
I love you all.
Yes. See you next Tuesday.
Yes. 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 Yes.